Hello YouTube, and now something what is pretty obvious for many people who collect vacuums and are those rapid vacuum enthusiasts. So okay, now let's just start. Packet vacuums are better in almost every way compared to the bagless vacuums. And I have done a lot of testing in my channel, and it has always been the case. Packet vacuums have been always better in many categories. Now, okay, let's start with the suction and airflow. Now we have to remember that, for example, these have same size motors, so 700 watt. But this, what is Sipo Felix, has much more airflow than this Dyson DC40 Mark II, and that's because this is so complicated, that air pad in this Dyson, that it will limit the performance. You can hear that actually when you turn the vacuum on, and if you take the pin off, you can hear the motor tone change because it is so restricted by the cyclone system in it. So also that is one thing, that motors go bad on bagless vacuums much more often than with the packet vacuums. So airflow and suction, that is what packet vacuums do better with same wattage motors. Now to the filtration and bag system versus bagless system. I have seen videos where people show very dirty bag compartment. Now, yes, if you don't have proper bags, if you have poor seal, that's going to happen. Some bags just can't filter well. But I have done seriously demanding test with my Miele C3 and sucking up that bag totally full and a lot of fine dust. So it was still very clean, that bag compartment. I didn't see anything in there, and the pre-motor filter was clean. So the bag is very important part of that filtration. And you have very good HEPA bag or fleece bag, like Miele has, it is keeping the dust in. So that is how packet vacuums collect the dust, simply to the bag. With the bagless vacuums, it sounds so tempting that you don't have to buy bags, but I come to that later. You dump it. I don't going to do that now because there is some dust, and that dust cloud what comes. Even how you try that, it always happens. You get the dust all over the pin. And because of this static electricity, it sticks to it. And not only the pin from the inside is dusty, but also the outside of the pin is dusty. And that's why you see a lot of bagless vacuums that are very dirty from outside, because that is going to happen if you don't constantly wipe that. Now that was the dust collecting and dirt collecting system. Now how about no loss of suction and airflow. Now that is what Dyson always claims, that they don't lose suction. They don't speak about airflow because it is quite weak. And I also say about that few things, why it matters so much. Now, yes, Dyson, I believe that Dyson will keep the suction and airflow, but what's the point? Because it is low to begin with. With the quality backer vacuum, you have very good airflow and suction, and even when you fill the bag, when you have quality bags, it is still very good and clearly better than the bagless vacuum. Now, why that airflow is so important? Now, let's take for example when you are using the hose and you are trying to get some dirt from the corner. Now, with the low airflow, you have to be very close to the object what you are trying to remove. But with the higher airflow vacuum, you don't need to see so much effort to do that. So it is making the vacuuming also easier. Now, yes, the cleaning here, of course it matters how it is designed, but these both have excellent cleaning hairs. And thing is that you are not always sealed to the carpet. For example, I have shown video where Dyson versus Kirby, when you are slightly off the carpet and there is some particles on the hard floor, then it is quite weak performing that removing that particles from the hard floors. Just tiny bit of loose of that cell and it is performing quite badly. That is the airflow thing. And that host usage also depends a lot of that airflow. Now, noise level, again, packet vacuums are more silent and they are quieter and often pleasing, more pleasing sounding than bagless vacuums. Now, why is that? Now, it is simply because the cyclonic system in bagless vacuums are making that extra noise. That is why bagless vacuums are so noisy. Now, of course, we have that EU with 80 decibel noise limit. That improves things, but it also makes them clean even worse because they don't allow more than 900 watt motors. So that's one thing again. And then there is that people, some people complain that, oh, I have to buy bags and I always have trouble to find bags. Okay, let's go to that. Now, if you have some very rare packet vacuum, then I understand that it is hard to find bags. But if you have even somewhat common vacuum, it is very easy just to order from internet. For example, if you order 6 bags, they last 6 months. And also those bags are not that expensive at all. And one bag will roughly last 1 month. And only thing what you have to do is take the bag out And like in this SIBO, it has that closing gap, so there is no that dust cloud at all. Throw it away, put new bag in, and you are again ready to go with 1 month. And in smaller apartments, more than that. So then we come to the filters. Now I know that Dyson has very good cyclonic system, and that filter doesn't need cleaning very often. This model recommends to do that once a month. But yes, you have to do that. You have to wash that filter once a month. Now with the packet vacuums, again, one benefit. Because the bag is so good filter, it really don't allow dust to go to the filter. So those filters stay clean a long time, much longer than with the bagless vacuums. So that's again one thing what is better with the packet vacuums. And obviously we have to remember that many bagless vacuums have very bad cyclonic system, so you have to constantly wash those filters. And that is the biggest mistake what people do. They don't keep the filters clean, and that is making things even worse. And that will overheat the motor, and in some vacuums the dust will go past the pre-motor filter and dirty the motor. So that will make the motor go bad in pretty short time. So that is one thing again. So I wanted to do this video because there was those claims that were totally wrong, and let's go to those quickly. So packet vacuums, quieter, better filtration, not that maintaining, very little maintaining compared to the bagless vacuums, more airflow, and yes. So benefit of bagless vacuums, you can see the dust what you pick up, and you don't need to buy bags. But like I said, those bad things, those cones and so on, it's not worth it. But to the end of this, I have to say that I still like bagless vacuums because it's, for me, it's not always that it has to be the best cleaning vacuum, because I want to experiment different vacuums and use them. And like I have said, this is my best bagless vacuum. It cleans carpets well because of this new cleaning head, what this has, that Mark II cleaning head. But there is problems when you are going to use them more often, and hose and so on, like I said, those problems what there is. So one last thing what I have to say is that packet vacuums tends to be better boiled than bagless vacuums. For example, if we take this SIBO Felix compared to this Dyson DC 40 Mark II, it is so much better boiled than SIBO Felix. Now for a bagless vacuum, this is pretty well made, but made in Malaysia, and this is made in German. So yes, there is a lot of misunderstanding, and some people are trying to convince that the bagless vacuum by Dyson especially is better, but those are proven, all those things wrong, and very easily proven. And I have some all those, so I don't even have to do any tests with those, because they constantly do time after time the same thing, and those results are constant. I didn't meant to upset anyone, this was not the purpose of that, this was just the facts why the packet vacuums are better. And again, reminder that I like a lot of bagless vacuums also, because it's not always about that which one is better, it's about enjoying your vacuums. So okay, now two same size motor vacuums, and packet one Sipo Felix is quite clearly better than the Dyson. And yes, I don't speak anymore because this video is plenty long already. All I want is to bring the truth to the public. So thank you for watching, and have a nice weekend what is coming, and Christmas. So goodbye.